Hello everyone. Installing the kohya-ss GUI for LoRA training on Linux can be a daunting task, especially for those interested in stable diffusion and AI art. But worry not. If you're passionate about stable diffusion and LoRA training in the realm of AI art, we have the solution you've been searching for. In this YouTube video, we'll walk you through the process of installing the kohya-ss GUI for stable diffusion and seamless LoRA training on Linux, making it hassle-free and accessible for everyone. So, if you're eager to explore the world of stable diffusion and dive into AI art with LoRA, stay tuned and let's get started together. Last time we installed the SD scripts programs for LoRA training on Linux. If you have not watched it yet, you can find the link here or in the description below. Okay, today we will install the GUI for the SD scripts program. First I want to check the version of my CUDA. In the terminal, type NVIDIA SMI. You can see that my CUDA version is 12.1. Next, we can start the installation. In the terminal, type git clone. And then the URL of the repository. Press enter. It will download all the codes for us. When it's done, let me add the folder to the workspace. We change the directory to the kohya-ss folder. To run the setup scripts, we need to give execute permission to the scripts first. We can now run the setup scripts. It will create the virtual environment for us and install all requirements. Okay, after the installation, we can configure the accelerator. To do this, in the terminal, type source.vn/bin/activate. After activating the virtual environment, we run the accelerate config command. Answer this machine. No. 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 All. FP16. Done. We can now run the GUI. In the terminal, type .gui.sh. Control click the link. We can now see the user interface. Since we are training LoRA model, we choose the Dream Booth LoRA tab. Here we can choose our base checkpoint model, the image dataset folders, the model output name, and all other training parameters. You can set the number of epochs here. Learning rate. The network dimension. Open the configuration file section. We can save and load all those settings using this feature. I have already prepared one config file. Press the load button to load the settings to the GUI. The base model is set to be the chill up mit model. The image dataset folder path and the output folder are all set. In the training parameters, I set epochs to 6. Vat size set is 2. Learning rate. Network dimension. Okay. Let's see how the image dataset should be set. Inside the dataset folder, we need to have another folder to hold our training images and the captions. The folder name is separated into two parts. The first part is the number of repeats. The second part is the class name. If we have caption files for the images, the class name will be ignored. After setting the correct folder structure, we can try to run. We can try printing the command first. The actual command to be run will be printed in the terminal. Okay. To actually train the LoRA model, we need to press the train button. Now press the train button to start training. Hey there. If you're enjoying the content so far, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. By hitting that subscribe button, you'll be the first to know when we release new videos. Don't forget to turn on notifications as well, so you never miss out. There is an error. What is it? It said that the correct bit and byte version is not found. No problem. Same as last time we installed the SD scripts. We can copy and paste the missing files to the bit and byte folder. You can go to my YouTube GitHub repository. Click code and download zip. Where do we need to put the files to? We can find it under the virtual environment side packages folder. This is the bit and byte folder. We can open the downloaded zip file. Drag and drop the missing files to the folder. It's done. What should we do next? We restart the GUI. Control C to close it. And then type GUI to start it again. We should not need to reload that page. Let's try print the command again. Okay. It worked. Press the train button to start training. It's now training. Good, this time the program can find the correct bit and byte library. We can see that the number means the number of repeats here. We have 20 images. So total, we have 540 trainings images. The class token is listed here. The caption extension is .txt. After it loaded the base model and bit and byte library, it started to train. This time the total steps needed are 1620. It will take approximately 13 minutes to finish. This is the output folder. Inside the output folder, there is a sample folder. After each epoch, it will generate one sample for us. We have 6 epochs. After 270 steps, we will have our first sample image. Okay. The training finished and these are the size sample images. It's quite good. Actually, it looked pretty like the target. if you'd like to see the log. We can type tensorboard log.dir, and then your log folder path. Click the link to open the results. Here is the curve for the loss in the training. We can see that the loss is decreasing during the training. Same here. These are the learning rate. There are 6 cycles. Because we use cosine with restarts in the training command, set the cycle to match our number epochs. The LoRA models are located in this folder. We have sized LoRA models here. Copy and paste it into the stable diffusion LoRA model and then you can use it. Thank you very much. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about stable diffusion and LoRA training, hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you never miss a video. I will put up the other video soon. You can also find all the models and images in my Patreon account. The link can be found in the description. Thank you and see you in the next video.